Okay, now the first real thing to do is just research online, look around for a show near in your area that you would like to attend. There's some pretty good resources that you can find on pretty much any audio forum, the audio forum here at Turn Pro, or Turn Pro's website, the DB Drag Racing website, has schedules of events. You could also look around for other organizations and local shows from things like Steve Mead Designs Forum. They have a Competitor's Corner section. So you look all around on there, as well as CarAudioClassifieds.org. They have their own section at the Competition Corner. You can just scroll in and look around for shows in your area. There's also regional websites like Midwest SPL and FloridaSPL.com. And this is the NSPL website, and I found a show 2 days from now on May 16th. At Poptronics in Parkville, Maryland. Now I know that's about a 2 hour drive from me, so that's pretty much as local as I could get nowadays. And they give a phone number, and it says it's a single point event. Now once you find the show you actually want to attend, it's a good idea to get all the information about the show itself together before you actually make the trip down. And since they give a phone number, I'm going to give a call and talk to the judge or promoter. Now it's also a good idea to look around and research on the website for that particular organization for all the rules of the show, how the shows run, and actually the classification that you would fit into, that your vehicle would fit into. Okay, it's starting to rain pretty good here. Luckily I have about 2 days to the show, but it's a good idea when you're on the phone with the judge or promoter to ask them if it's rain or shine, weather dependent, if it's indoors or outdoors as well. That'll help you prepare. And also, when you're taking the trip down, make sure you take items such as sunblock, maybe an umbrella. If it's cold, maybe an extra sweatshirt, an extra t-shirt in case it's too hot, bottles of water, things like that. And I'll go over some more of that. Sunblock is important, especially for us fair-skinned folk, because I got some sunburn on my nose. Also, when you're on the phone with the judge or on the internet, figure out how much registration fees are, and then try and figure out how much gas you'll need, toll money, anything like that, and get all your money together. And if you don't have any, maybe your team will help you out. So talk to your team about that as well. And take extra tools and materials as spares, just in case. You know, it's always a good idea to pack a screw gun with all the bits that you need, flathead, star, square bits, Phillips especially. Pack your meters, you know, clamp meter, your voltage meter, any kind of wire cutters, crimpers, strippers, bigger wire crimpers, tape measure, just in case, you never know. Some needle nose pliers, metal razor knife, in case you need to pull panels off, get a panel pop, pencil, in case you need to mark stuff. Got wire ties, double-sided tape, some excess power, just in case you need it. About some glue, a little magnet, extra screws, maybe even just spare pieces of wood that are laying around, you never know. And a hammer, manual screwdriver, some tape, duct tape, electrical tape, maybe even some spare pieces of wire always come in handy, and some spare ring terminals. If you have extra fuses, if you use fuses, make sure you pack some extra fuses. And if you have a socket set, some sockets, a rocket, just in case you need a rocket. Now about testing, if you have access to a Term Lab or other great meter, it's always good to test before the show, a couple days before the show. Make sure you get your frequency down and you know what numbers that you're expecting. Any little change you do, like moving the seats, placing a bag in the back, holding on your hatch, you have to retest for frequency. Okay, here's a few tips. Your frequency will change. Even if you have a sunroof cover that you slide forward, then your frequency might change, so you might want to test for that. You will want to test for that. Just make sure that you have your frequency down with all the stuff in the car the way you're going to have it at the show. Also test in various weather conditions. If it's a little bit rainy out or if it's a sunny day, your frequency might change. So test for that as well. Make sure you have all your parameters down and you know exactly what you're going to expect. Another little tip from a veteran is once you have everything set in your vehicle to hit your peak SPL,
you know, your seat position, which doors to hold, box position, things like that. Do not change it without testing. Don't go to the show and someone says, hey, I think it'll be louder if you just move your box up a little bit. Don't do it, because you most likely will go down. You have a 50-50 shot. Unless you test and are sure it's going to go up, do not change anything. Now, if you don't have access to a meter, we'll go over a little quick testing at the show and show you how to really use the judge's meter to do a few quick tests in the lanes before the actual official run, if it's possible. Also, make sure you just have everything prepared, that all the discs that you used for testing, all the songs, the tracks, you have all those in your car ready to go. I usually leave my official disc in the CD player the whole week before the show and during the show, just to make sure that it's in there. Also, just make sure that everything's ready on the car. You get gas the night before, you fill up on gas.
And remember, get your Google Maps printed out, the address queued into your GPS, and get a good night's sleep.
Now, best thing to do is once you get to the show is find your parking spot and then head right over to the judges' booth. This way you could get registration out of the way and not have to worry about it, so you could make any repairs, clean your car, just hang out and talk. And also, if you get there early enough, maybe they have time to let you test if you haven't already done so. Hi, I need to register for the show.
Hi, how are you? Can you just fill out this form for me, please?
All right. And when are we going to run up?
I'd be ready in about an hour.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
Now, can I have some time to test for my frequency?
Sure, I'll give you two runs if you bring it up right now.
All right, thanks. I'll go get it. Now, two runs are perfect, because look at this here. On the DB Jam CD, on all of them actually, you have track 7 and 8 are sweeps. So what you actually do is, for your first run, which is 30 seconds, you cue up track 7, you play track 7, then you skip right to track 8, and you ask the judge what your peak frequency is after the run. So playing those sweeps will play the full frequency range that you can play, and do it at about 3/4 volume of what your max volume is, and that'll tell you your peak frequency. And now all the other tracks, starting at 20, is that particular frequency. So whatever that frequency the judge told you, for your second run, play that track plus one or two tracks above it at full volume. And that'll tell you what you're going to expect SPL-wise and what your exact frequency is. Ask him again on that second run what actual frequency was the peak.
While you're at the show and after you register, actually take time to enjoy the show. Just sit down, relax, talk to friends, find any veterans, take some notes, ask some questions about boxes and about the cars, stuff like that. If they let you, take pictures of all the other setups around you to learn. Any questions you think you have, don't be afraid to ask them. Just ask someone who looks like they know what they're talking about, and ask the judges as well. The judges are a wealth of knowledge.
You don't have to be in a rush to pull your car up to the lanes. There's going to be a mad dash sometimes. You can either, number one, be one of the first cars, get it out of the way so you could just sit down, relax, and enjoy the show, or just wait and hold off until the mad dash gets done and wait to be one of the last cars.
Ready, set, go, 30 seconds.
First place in the 139.9 class was Nick Garcia. He's got a $50 store credit to Poptronics.